Hello, it's another edition of Plus Report, a compilation of the stories and events that made the news recently. Welcome, I'm Jacinta Obioku. We are kick-starting with the 45th anniversary of Oduwa's Investment Company Limited, a company owned by the six southwest states of Oyo, Ondo, Ogun, Osun, Ekiti, and Lagos State. The keynote speaker at the event opined that management is one thing that has led the country as a region corporate entity entrusted with public resources and legacy, where it is economically. Lovey Kukoyedekun has details in this report.
Celebrating 45 years of business operation in a harsh economic reality, such as the situation in Nigeria today, could be worth the while. Sons and daughters of Oduwa, business moguls and captains of industries, all were represented here. For guest speaker Dotun Suleiman moved them to a change of mindset, to question the past and embrace new ideas.
Where were we when Abuja was being built from scratch, from ground zero? What did we do? What part of that we own? And where were we when all the oil blocks were being auctioned? We're a late entry into the game that we have been playing for 40, 50 years. Now, the question therefore is that, how do we characterize the last 45 years? To me, I'm asking myself, doesn't a squandering of inherited riches sound rather apt?
Lagos State Governor Babajide Sanwo-Olu was represented by his deputy, Obafemi Hamzat. He tried to provide answers to questions posed by the speaker.
But I think it's important for us to know that the future beacons, and we have a responsibility to accelerate the process of transforming this legacy company. It's a legacy company, and the vision of our forefather, you can't just but marvel. This is a time when they don't have computers. This was the time when they only have probably typewriters. So for them to even put that vision together is just unbelievable. So they were genius.
Pa Ayo Okpadukun would rather talk on regionalism and restructuring, though not losing sight of the legacies of the founders of Oduwa conglomerates.
If what the progress we are making between 52 and 59 are continued, we'll be competing with Israel today. No one would done that. It is the foundation that led the northern region to found their own development corporation. We are always blazing the trail.
The theme of the anniversary is celebrating 45 years of dynamic transformation of the Western region into a big conglomerate. From Lagos, Love Ikuku Oyedokun for Plus TV Africa.
Reactions have continued to trail the arrest of 14 persons, including a journalist who allegedly posed as security personnel and raided the home of the second most senior judicial officer in Nigeria, Justice Mary Odili. Spokesperson for the ex-president Ibrahim Babangida harped on the need for Nigeria's security system to rid itself of disconnection and dislocation from the citizens, and the need for the judiciary to begin to clean their house so as to avert future occurrence. Plus TV Africa's correspondent Destiny Momo has more.
The judiciary, as it is always said, is the last hope of the common man. This claim is predicated upon its role in protecting the rights of every person, corporation and organization against violation by the strong in the society. Justice Mary Odili's home invasion has been seen as an eye-opener to members of the judiciary to take advantage of private security practice to secure their home and environs. Governor Wike also speaks on the need for the judiciary to be protected as he personalized the humiliation on Justice Odili.
Unfortunately, while the present federal government has been very weak in resourcing and strengthening the judiciary, it has been very strong and readily predisposed.
The judiciary as an arm of government has been said to be relegated to the financial dependence of the executive arm of government in Nigeria, hence the many challenges faced. Spokesman of former President Ibrahim Babangida and National Secretary retired members of Nigerian Armed Forces spoke on how brutish and barbaric such invasions warrants bring.
At the scene of that crime, alarms, you know, were raised, and I was expecting the police at that point, if they are not culpable, to have gone to make arrests on the spot.
Security vulnerability. For an example, if there were family members in that house at that time, how do you think their lives would have been secured? If we are finding now that these guys are criminal elements not supported by the state actors.
They also lend their expertise on the need for the Attorney General of the Federation and the legal structure to clean their house to stop such embarrassment from resurfacing, saying the AGF have such powers because the silence of President Buhari has given him a conscienceless power.
And it's also a reminder to the judges and justices of the Supreme Court that they should not continue to cultivate all manners of bestialities in the way and manner they dispense with justice.
Attorney General of the Federation, you saw the embarrassment. So let them begin to clean the house. If this man is found wanting, they should remove his son and let's see if it's possible.
Attack on Justice Mary Odeli goes to show that the citizenry are all in endangered times. Meanwhile, according to police spokesman Mr. Frank Mba, the 14 suspects and 7 others now at large conspired to raid the residence following information that the Supreme Court justice was keeping a large sum of money in foreign currencies. Destiny Mama for Plus TV Africa.
A lot of people believe that the arrest made so far by the Nigerian police will not only restore the sanctity of the nation's judicial system, but will also be seen to have restored public confidence in the administration of justice. On nation building now, the Igbo and Yoruba community leaders in the Northeast Nigeria have called for the unity of the country, noting that with fairness and equity, the nation will overcome its threatening situations. They believe that individual or regional interests should not be above collective interest.
The 34th National Festival of Art and Culture is currently holding in Ekiti State. Contingents from 36 states of the Federation arrived the state to showcase the rich cultural values of their different states. This is just as the state governor, Kayode Fayemi, promised the continuous support for the cultural development of Ekiti State and Nigeria at large. Fayemi declared the event open in Ado-Ekiti. He also stressed that the cultural festival will provide them an opportunity to learn and enjoy the rich culture, hospitality, and goodwill the state is endowed with.
The burden of our national commitment, which has rested solely on the performance of our crude oil in the international market, has continued to render the nation immobile. This calls for innovative and creative solutions. Investing in culture is crucial to the general development of any society. Culture impacts on economic growth by strengthening social virtues, creating trust which facilitates relationships, and inspiring motivation that stimulates entrepreneurship.
The Director General, National Council for Arts and Culture, and President, World Crafts Council, African Region, Olusegun Runsewe, explained that NAFEST provides a platform for Nigerians from different ethnic backgrounds to showcase their unique cultural manifestation.
Nigeria is one entity, and we are unity, and nothing can separate us. NAFEST is a brand that came up after the Civil War in 1970. And today you can see what's happening in Ekiti. It's telling a story of a people united and being together. For me, it's a platform to embrace what unites us than what separates us. NAFEST is a brand that have changed the narrative of this country. Some people have told you some stories about Ekiti, about Nasarawa, about Ogun, but all of them are here. That's to tell a story to the world that this country, we are together.
He added that it also brings to fore the role of culture in national peace and harmony, as well as the vast opportunity in the culture sector for job creation and economic empowerment. He called on the participants in all the competitive events to go into them in the spirit of sportsmanship, adding that the essence of the events was to build friendship as brothers of the same nation.
The Southern leaders insisted that oneness of the nation is not negotiable and urged separatists to shelve such idea for collective interest. On security matters now, the Chief of Defense Staff General Loki Irabo has advised officers of the Joint Task Force Operation Delta Safe and personnel of other security agencies in the Niger Delta not to relent in maintaining peace in the region. General Irabo made this call during a visit to the headquarters of Operation Delta Safe in Yenagoa, Bayelsa State. He said security is everyone's responsibility, adding that all residents must work together for the sustenance of peace in the region.
This is General Loki Irabo's maiden visit to the Joint Task Force in the South-South, codenamed Operation Delta Safe. The Chief of Defense Staff is grateful to the JTF commander and his men for working tirelessly to ensure there is peace and security in the region. The visit is meant to serve as a morale booster to the officers and to also provide an interactive session with those involved in the exploration of Nigeria's oil and gas resources. General Irabo hopes to have more of such meetings.
Meeting primarily one to speak to the commander. I can assure you is that there certainly have to be a scale-up of what you now see. They've done incredibly well, I must say, and of course that will be sustained. And in the near future, we will see a near zero incident regarding both insecurity and also crude oil theft.
General Loki Irabo uses the avenue to inspect ongoing projects in the OPDS headquarters and commissions a newly built gymnasium. The commander of Operation Delta Safe, Rear Admiral Abubakar Al-Hassan, appreciates the CDS for the visit and for always responding promptly to the needs of the JTF.
Only about 2 weeks ago, the CDS was at the Nigerian Navy Shipyard Limited, Port Harcourt, to launch 4 gunboats for the OPDS, while on the same day, he awarded contracts to the shipyard for the construction of 6 new ones for this operation.
The Chief of Defense Staff proceeds to visit and encourage officers of 16th Brigade of the Nigerian Army, the Mobility Command Nigerian Air Force, and finally, the Central Naval Command Headquarters, where he's given a warm reception.
While he was at headquarters of Operation Delta Safe, he addressed the personnel. Before then, he had had a meeting with stakeholders in the oil and gas sector. The primary reason why he's here is to hold a discussion or to address the officers.
The CDS is also full of thanks to the people of the Niger Delta region for the cordial working relationship with the security agencies over the years. Jesse Ese, Plus TV News, Yenagoa.
We will now go on a short break and we'll be right back with more.